Ahoy, and welcome back to my playthrough of Jenny LeClue.
That sword looks like it might move. How am I going to get up there? Thank you. got it. Some days you just feel super smart.
Jenny studied the stone discs, now perfectly aligned.
It's the face of a badger. That's unusual. Something tells me this isn't a tomb.
If the huge coiling wires hadn't made it clear, the hulking metallic shell certainly did.
This isn't a tunnel. It's the entrance to another laboratory, just like the one in the forest. How many of these are there?
The presence of such unusual and foreign objects in Atherton begged even bigger questions.
Who put them here? And for what purpose?
It seemed to Jenny as if the graveyard itself had been built around the sphere. A perfect hiding place. If something this conspicuous could be so easily concealed.
What else is Atherton hiding? We know it's working.
As a dozen intricate machines whirred to life, Jenny noticed a remarkable resemblance she had overlooked before.
Some of this equipment looks like the stuff in Susie's lab. Can't believe I missed it before. That girl owes me some answers. Another radio. Maybe these are used to communicate between laboratories.
It was a hunch, but if it were true...
Whoever's transmitting the message could be in another sphere somewhere in town. Voices before.
This code was different from the last.
Just as strange, though.
Jenny carefully transcribed the words into her journal.
Let's see what the hawk and the weasel have to say about this.
Thank you.
Purge infected, soon only death. Forever silenced, despair herself is near.
This message, as sinister as the last, sent Jenny's analytical mind into overdrive.
Is the man in black sending these messages?
Purge infected, forever silenced.
Could that have something to do with Dean Strawsbury? It can't be a coincidence that I found a copy of the same book by the Dean's corpse. But how are they connected?
Soon only death, despair herself is near.
And now they're coming for my mom. What does she know that they're willing to kill her for?
This contraption was new to Jenny, but something about it caught her eye.
Doesn't seem to be working. Probably just a loose connection somewhere.
Piece of rare Arthurtonian quartz, expertly carved and shaped with meticulous precision.
Could be an antenna, or maybe a power coil. But where does it get its power? It looks like the arm rotates around this hinge. Ugh, I can't budge it. It's too heavy.
Jenny knew that the best way to fix anything electronic was...
to mess around with it until all the lights come on.
Being a great detective didn't work out. Jenny had a promising career in machine repair to fall back on. A large metallic slab with a distinctive indentation carved into its surface.
That shape. Where have I seen it before? The Dean's ring! Fits.
In fact, it fit perfectly into the slot, as though it were made for it. The machine's true application would remain a mystery, for now. But whatever its purpose, the implications were overwhelming.
Dean Strawsbury is somehow connected to this place.
Had the Dean been aware of the secret hiding within his ring?
Whether he knew or not, it's likely he was killed because of it.
Hidden amongst a web of cables, the average eye would have missed it. But Jenny LeClue was a great detective.
There's a book pinned beneath that cable.
Confidential. The word was music to Jenny's ears.
Zazer.
Jenny recognized the name, but couldn't put her finger on where she'd heard it before.
So this lab is his invention. He called it a Zazer sphere. Well, at least I've got a name. These machines were built to study and harness the power of Arthurton's greatest resource. They were experimenting on the town itself. Council of Three. Never heard of them. Sounds like he didn't know who they were either. But they paid for all of this? He designed a bigger sphere. Bigger than this? Did he ever build it? And if he did, where? There was a badger on the door to get into this lab. So this must be the experiment he was talking about. Exhaustion, rushed schedule, dangerous conditions.
The parallels with her father's own working conditions were distressingly clear.
All dead. All my fault.
The words echoed across the metal walls, ghosts of a past tragedy.
What did he do? It must have been terrible. This entry is from much later. There are lots of pages missing. It seems that whatever happened before, he carried on his work long after.
As is the case in all tangled mysteries, every new piece of evidence raised more questions than it answered. But she now knew the purpose of this Zazer sphere and the name of the people who had built it.
The Council of Three.
It wasn't much to go on, but it was a start.
Another blank scrap of paper.
Please enter authorization code to begin.
1028.
Code accepted. System authorized and armed for activation. Preparing to run experiment 12, cycle 78. Sphere hermetically sealed. Magnetic transducer coils charging.
Accumulating voltaic cells.
Commencing experiment 12-91.
Radioactive safety margins cleared. Procedure 12 completed successfully. Decompressing spherical chamber.
Remember, a healthy employee is
an effective employee. Please leave the station for your mandatory 15-minute smoking break.
I wonder what it did. At least I wasn't covered in plasma.
Okay, that's all for now. Thanks for watching. Be sure to like, comment, and subscribe.